Hi guys, welcome to Yeti's Place. This is Yeti the Samoyed and I'm Yeti's mom. And on today's episode, what makes a Samoyed a working dog? We're going to discuss that on today's Yeti's Place. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe, hit that bell notification, and check out our links down below. If you're back for more videos, welcome back. We really appreciate you taking the time to watch our channel. What makes a Samoyed a working dog? They were bred in Siberia as working dogs. They used to be reindeer herders. Yes, you used to herd reindeer years ago, long time ago. And you used to be a sled puller, yet he still wants to pull sleds. And they used to haul supplies around for their owners. And then at nighttime, the owners would bring them into their houses with them, and they would let the Samoyeds sleep on their beds and cuddle around them. And the Samoyeds actually used to sleep on top of their owners, acting as a nice insulated blanket. They are great at herding. They're great agility dogs as well. They're just a little bit slower than most agility dogs as far as their speed goes, but they love agility competitions. They are extremely intelligent dogs, but don't let their stubbornness fool you, because their stubbornness actually shows you that they are more intelligent than you think they are, because they want to do what they want to do when they want to do it. Don't you, Yeti? Yeah, that's why you don't like listening to your mom most of the time, unless your mom gets out the camera and films YouTube. They are extremely stubborn. Yeti thinks he's smarter than most of his people, except me. He knows that I'm the master, so he thinks that I'm smarter than he is. If he does not feel that I'm smarter than he is, well, then he has a temper tantrum like a 2-year-old child does. He will scream, he will bark, he will sass, he will howl whenever I tell him to do something that he doesn't want to do. Most of the time, Yeti doesn't want to do that thing unless I have a treat. If I have a treat, well then Yeti pays attention to me. Anything you don't want a Samoyed to do, they're gonna do, unless they're tired. So a good way to help tire out a dog, to keep them from doing those bad things, is you have to walk them. Bring them on a few mile walk in the morning and then in the evening. In the morning you can walk them like a half mile to a mile, and then at nighttime, again, do the same type of thing. Let them play all day long with you and also with their toys. Create like a game for them, like a pulling game and a herding game. Then they will be great dogs. They will listen to you. They will want to do what you want them to do. They will not be destructive, because a bored Sammy is not a good Sammy. Bored Sammies get very destructive very quickly. Like if you, for example, want to leave them in your backyard for a few minutes to maybe a half hour to run off some extra energy, and they get bored back there, well, very, very quickly, you guys are gonna have a giant, huge, massive hole dug in your backyard. In a period of 3 minutes, Quimby, who has appeared on other episodes in the past, period of 3 minutes, I'm not kidding, he had dug a hole that was a person-sized hole. Like as long as a person, as long as a human adult, and wider than a human adult, and a good 3 feet deep, because he was bored in our backyard. Inside the house, if they get bored, they will eat your carpeting, which is why we now have wood floors in our house, thanks to Chewy, our late Samoyed, having shredded our carpet, because we didn't know exactly how to work with a Samoyed when we got Chewy. He shredded the carpet, he ate the windowsills, he ate our surround sound speakers, he ate everything in the house. He ate our furniture in our house too. Oh my goodness, it was crazy. So then we finally figured out that, oh okay, yeah, maybe we should walk him a few times a day. Then he became a perfect dog. So Yeti was bred to be a sled puller. And Yeti on his walks with his dad, his dad always tells me that, oh my goodness, we got a sled dog. Because Yeti pulls and pulls and pulls really, really hard. Now my husband stands 6'4". He's a tall guy, really, really tall guy. And Yeti pulls him really hard. His grandpa or great grandpa, I'm sorry, I can't remember which one he was specifically, pulled literally over a ton, winning a pulling competition. And he was Yeti's size. Samoyeds love pulling things. They love working. Letting them do what they were bred to do is really, really important with a Samoyed, because Samoyeds love to work. And so when they're working, they are happiest. And when they're happy, they're not destroying your house. They are gentle with kids, which is wonderful if you have a family. Same with if you have cats around, they will play very, very nicely with cats. But you have to get them used to the cats. And you have to have them think that, okay, a cat is not like a woodchuck, not like a skunk, not like a wild animal. This is our pet, and we love the cat, and they too will love the cat. So because Yeti is a working dog, he rebels whenever we leave him home alone. Like, Yeti will get upset at us, he will race around in circles, he will bark like crazy whenever we leave him home by himself, and he has rummaged through a garbage can. He's knocked the garbage can over and rummaged through it. He has stolen my husband's socks out of my husband's duffel bag because Yeti is mad that his dad is not there to play with him, and his dad is not there to work with him and to have him pull my husband arm off. So my parents actually have a dog sled, and the dog sled used to be pulled by our late Sammy Ed and another late Sammy Ed. They loved doing that. They would always get so excited to go out and dog sled pull. Yeti, in fact, one day we had Yeti over at our niece's and nephew's house. They had a dog sled hooked up, and Yeti was pulling them on the dog sled. He was barking and having all types of fun pulling them. So we actually did a video where, because I don't own the dog sled, we did a video where Yeti was able to pull me on a kid's sled. It was like one of those plastic sleds. And I hooked Yeti up to his leash and I held onto it. I'm like, mush Yeti, mush, go, go, go. So Yeti started running and pulling me, and he was barking, having all types of fun. And I was laughing because it was so much fun having Yeti pull me. But he loves doing that. That is what they are meant to do. They can also run in dog sledding races. They won't be super fast running in them, but they do love to participate in those. If you have rollerblades, you can hook your dog up onto a leash and the dog will love to pull you. If you have a bicycle that has the attachment for a dog to sit next to you and to run and to play, I have it linked down below if you guys wanna check that out. But it hooks up onto the side of your bicycle so that they can get some exercise while you're also exercising too. They will be super happy about helping you with your exercises, as well as it helps tire them out, which is a good thing for both people and dogs. Well, thank you so much, you guys, for coming back and for watching us some more on Yeti's Place. If you're new here, please be sure to subscribe and click that bell notification. Check out all the links down below, because we'll link some really fun stuff to use for your Sammy Ed's energy levels. And if you have another breed of dog, they will also help with helping exhaust that other breed. So thanks so much for watching, you guys. You have a great day. Thanks.